What's up, YouTube? Thanks again for checking me out today. It's your boy KG. I'm always gonna be, from now on, I'm gonna be uploading some new videos, man. So I'm gonna be here. You know, if you guys are here or you find yourself on my channel more than once, and do me a favor and subscribe. You know, it really help out to just be able to, you know, get to 100 subscribers. That's my main goal here. So if you guys could help me out, that would be really awesome. So we'll just get right into it. The reason that these two slots are empty is because I was putting cards here and I was taking them out, and they were like a little bit like warped on the inside. So that was really disappointing. But yeah, I mean, nothing's really perfect, so I wasn't really like mad, but yeah, that's why that's empty. So you have Vampire Frawling and then Dimensional Shifter. Obviously, D Shifter's cracked. Frawling is just a cool card. I like it. Stops attacks and stuff like that. Can beat over stuff by paying life points. Impermanence, Soul Scissors. These are, you know, pretty much hand traps. This card can be special summoned when something's destroyed. So, I mean, it's not necessarily a hand trap, but yeah, it's in my hand trap binder, so I digress. But let's see, we have the Gammas. These are original prints from High Speed Riders. I'm not sure if you can see that. Obviously the original driver. This one negates traps or spells, and this one negates the other one, I don't remember. I just have these because they're searchable off of the Link 2, and I was playing that in one of my Mech Knight builds because they're psychics and there's some shenanigans you could do there. But moving on, we have the Irish Sword Souls. Never played it. Token Collectors, never played it. Serenus's, love this card, I have played it. Lord, also played it, really good card. Skullmeisters, these are collector's rares. I got tacked for those, but I really liked them. These are from the Speed Dual Packs. DD Crows, had ultis but sold them once I quit the game. Let's see, Ally of Justice, Psycho Reader, it's a machine, searchable. Droll, you know, everyone needs a Droll. I think these are cards that I feel like you should just have in your arsenal. Yeah, I had ultis of Veilers and Droll and Lockbirds, but once again, sold them once I quit the game. Once I tried to quit the game. But I made really good money off of them. You know, I was able to like get my first like really nice car. So it was cool. You know, no regrets. You know, you can't live life that way. I miss them, obviously, but it's all good. We have Lava Golems. These are retro pack Lava Golems. Let's see if I can get that on there. These are from the retro pack, they're cool. And then just original print sphere modes, Ghidorahs, the reprints, a bunch of random kaijus. I think there's double gamma seal, yeah. So double gamma seal, triple Santa Claus. This card is searchable off Sane Game, and you can still use it, so that's neat. And then we have the Ghost Ogres. I said in a previous video, you'll have the secrets. These are the secret ones. Then I have the Reapers. If you look at my Reapers, they're all like, they're all the sexy ones. The ones that like have that diamond in the back. So those all are really cool. And then original print Bells, first editions, original print Dogwoods, original print Moonlit Joes, reprint Ghost Ogres, reprint Reapers, reprint Ashes. And if you look at these are in the order that they were released. So Ogre was released in Cross Souls. This is a reprint, but it was originally released, I want to say Shining Victories, with like some of the blue eye shit. So that came out next, and then Ashes in a deck, you know, and then so on and so forth. These are in order, like chronologically, essentially. So that's cool. And then, like I said, still in order chronologically, just the reprints, the alternate arts. These cards look cool. So, you know, I think they look awesome, so I have them. And then Gores, these ones are like the Duelist Leagues. They're all different colors. One's red, one's blue, one's green. And the Primineral Congrade. This is a hand trap. It's trash, but it is a hand trap. Just in case you don't know what it does. Must be special summoned by a card effect. If a monster is sent from the opponent's hand or deck to the graveyard, you can special summon this card and face down in defense position. If this card is flipped face up, you can target up two cards on the field, destroy them. So, I've never played it, but it's got 3,000 attack, 2,000 defense, level 8. So you can do shenanigans with it. It's a card that is real, so it exists. Not that you ever play it, but like I said, it's a real card. I like it. Spending too much time talking about this trash card. Okay, so Contact C, Trap Eater, Balusha, or Lutia, no material. Fun fact, back when I was a scrub, a long ass time ago, I traded 2 no materials for 2 OT Galateas. You gotta roast me for that, bro. Like, I should never be able to live that down. I don't even know, bro. You know, like I said, I was so trash, bro. I needed guidance and I just didn't have anybody. I didn't have anyone. So, it was a rough road, man. But, you have Chaos Hunters over here. These are first edition from the First Edition Secrets from... I'm gonna say Storm of Ragnarok. Give me in the comments if I'm wrong. This is Phantasme. These are original prints. I pulled 2 of these, fun fact. The third one I bought, but I still have all 3 of them. I never sold them, just kept them. The reprint nibs, the secret reprint nibs, I like those better than the tin ones. I have the tin ones in one of my for sale binders, which I will go through soon. I'm gonna go through all my binders, like I said, but. Maxis, these are just commons. I've never had old tees. The highest rarity I had was secrets of those. And you know, I sold those before I stopped playing. I just like they went up in price, so I was like, yeah, I gotta get rid of these. This card's never coming back. I hope this card never comes back. Like, you know, if that's a discussion, I don't even think that's like worth the discussion personally. Like, that card should just not come back. I shouldn't have to use my ash like to play. Like, I don't know, whatever. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you should have to use your Ash to play. Like, on Mazra Duel, I'm always using my Ash just to stop a Maxi. Like, it gets annoying. But, I mean, I guess that is why Ash is so good. I don't know, whatever. Gizmex. So, Orochis. Kakus. This card steals extra deck monsters. Naganaki. This card will special summon any of the Gizmex. Special summons a machine monster whose attack equals its defense. But and then it banishes to add like a banishment. So like it does some stuff. It's whatever. It does an ultra rare. This card splashes from deck, or splashes from hand, and then you can splash it from deck if your opponent does something. It's a cool hand trap. I don't know. I have a lot of these too. I got them for like $1, so I have a lot of those. Alpha is one of my favorite cards. I have a Starlight of these. Only one. Mirrodora's. Also one of my favorite cards. I have Starlands of these as well, a full playset. But that card's really cheap, so I was able to get those cheap. And then Battle Faders, Secret Rare First Edition, those are cool. I wish I had ulties. My friend back in the day had ulties. I was always jealous of those. Swift Scarecrows, these are super rares from the Astro Pack. Those are really cool. Speedrun Minko, these are like battle hand traps. I used to love this card. I was playing like a rank 4 deck when everyone was playing Pepe. Like I said, was trash. And I was getting stomped, but I was stopping battle phases. So that was cool. I was putting monsters in defense mode and there was no link monster. So we were out here. Dark Honest. I don't know. It's like on, you know, I don't even know. I just have that, I guess. Cock-a-doodle-doo. Hoppier Squadron. These are not even hand traps. Some of these are just cards that are just in here. Bestials. These are in a some of these are in their deck. Magnemites I actually sold recently because someone wanted to pay 20 for them. So, you know, is what it is. If you're playing, I think you know, if at the time you were playing, you may have needed them, but I personally would not spend that much on that card. That's why I got rid of it. But all this stuff. I've never used these. I just kind of bought them because they're meta. And then and they were $1, so whatever. These cards, like I said, I was playing these. I was playing like the common versions at the time, but I love these cards. Like a long time ago. This is a hand trap. When you have no cards and it's the only card in your hand, if your opponent monsters attacks, you can discard the card, destroy as many cards as they control as possible, and then special summon a monster from your deck. So this card just like gets you back in the game, but I probably never ever play that card. You have to have nothing, literally. So, you know, you have to be like losing. So, you know, I don't know. I feel like cards that are good when you're losing are like not optimal because you don't want to be losing. But another conversation. The Wind Witches, love these cards. These cards are awesome. These are the original prints. These are the secrets because they look awesome. Wind Witches are cool. Pacifist deck. Like I said, I think I got through all my hand traps, so I just like put some like, deck cores in here. These are not part of the Pacifist deck, but they're part of like the water control, like this deck. But Beautiful, that's close with the sharks. There's no room with the rest of the sharks. Some more sharks, some more cards. Shark. This card is a water monster that special summons when it's into the graveyard by a card effect. So you can like do Gars, or like the Gars plays with this card. Foolish Burial plays with this card. Just ways to like extend using this card. Astral Karibo, another card that extends. The Rescue Package. These are the rescue monsters that I like. This card's cracked, bro. Like, this card is really good. And then this card's also cracked. This card's also cracked. Like, some of these rescue monsters are just insane. Like, if you put them in the right scenario, they just shine so bright. These cards are obviously nice. The original, or not the original, but the Astral Packs. This card does burn damage. It's trash. But it is from the Advent Calendar. Phantom Knights. I like the cards, but I'll probably never play them again. Livianir, this is a collector's rare. Banker Tops, can I get that on there? No. Yeah, I'm trash. I don't know if you guys can even see that, but it is collector's rare. It's near mint, pretty decent. Got it when it like went down a little bit. Retaliating Sea, some Nemesis monsters. These cards are actually really nice. Shouldn't sleep on these. Retaliating Sea, I don't think that card's any good. There is a new sea monster being printed though that is kind of nice. I forget exactly what the effect is, but it's like not but. So yeah, I mean, thanks for checking me out always. Hope you guys have a good day. Take care.